And if ever you decide, you should go. There is a taste of time, sweet and honey, down the
tell you about Ahab, the Arab. She got the burning sands and an empty room. It's just a dribbin' off of him and a ring on every finger of his hand. And a big old turban wrapped about his head and a scimitar by his side. And every evening about midnight, he'd jump on his camel named Clyde and ride silently through the night, where he would secretly meet up with Fahima, the number one dance and his daughter, and the Sultan's whole harem. Like him and her had a tango, you know, and he'd been carrying on for some time now behind the Sultan's back. And you could hear him talk to his camels. He rode out across the dunes, and his voice cut through the still desert night air as he said, which is Arabic for, whoa, babe. And Clyde said, that's camel talk. Well, he brought his camel to a screaming halt in the rear of Fahima's tent. Now he jumped off Clyde, snuck around the corner and into the tent. Now he went, he saw Fahima laying on a zebra skin rug with a on her fingers and bells on her toes and a bone in her nose. Ho, ho. Yeah. There she was, friends and neighbors lying there in all of her Arabian beauty. She was eating on a raisin and an apricot and a pomegranate, a bowl of chitlins, two bananas, three Hershey bars, sipped on an RC Cola while she listened to transistor radio. Candle operator on a transistor radio, and she chewed beach nut gum, liniment flavor. And Ahab walked up to her, and my friends, this is what he said. Which is Arabic for, let's twist again like we did last summer, babe. And she said, a story about Ahab, the Arab, but she got the burning sands. And it was true, it's just a ribbon of a hem and a ring on every finger of his hand. Had a big old turban wrapped about his head and a scimitar by his side. And every evening about midnight, he'd jump on his camel and pack.